It really surprised me how it started like a young adult story and then evolved in a much more tense way until it became a very intense, ruthless, and beautiful experience. So I saw the opportunity of using the filmmaking language in order to help that story grow and be built the right way, the accurate way, and the powerful way. I think we are intending to elevate this original story in order to create something very powerful visually and also very elegant. So we can tell the story of this teenager and the struggle that being a teenager is in a very accurate and stylized way. I think as an editor, even when I write as an editor. And when I develop a project, I also see the scenes not in a literary way, but in terms of pace and even cut. So when you get the material as a director, in a way you feel that you are getting the primary material in order to really make the film afterwards. So you don't simply cover everything from every point of view, like everything could be done in a neutral way. But I try to use language and go from here to there, using the sequential art in order to create something on the posterior craft, which is the edit. We are trying to do the effects in a very rooted and grounded way, so everything has a very physical perception. So when we have even the presence of evil or these creatures from the other side or whatever, they are always tangible, physical, and real. It doesn't matter if they don't belong to our world. They are never transparent ghosts, trespassing walls, or anything like that. If you are, I don't know, alone in an attic, and you are in the middle of the darkness, you don't see anything, and there's a lightning. If you see a dragon, that's okay. It's probably scary. But if there's 12 people looking at you, it's probably scarier. So we are doing that with everything, including the fire. We are using real fire to make the house really burn. And even when we use CGI, it's starting by very physical and tangible techniques. Everything you're gonna see here is gonna be real. Kit is us, and we are Kit. She's gonna guide our eyes, and we are gonna feel things through her. She's a young lady who's trying to figure out the kind of woman she's gonna eventually become. She's constantly struggling against the rest of the world because she feels this tension every teenager feels. When you think that everything is hostile around, she's so bold, she's eager to do what needs to be done no matter the risk, but she's not unconscious. She's observant, she looks around, she analyzes things, and she acts. Madame Duret is the most extraordinary character because in theory, in a gothic film, and this is not a gothic film at all, you would expect her to be Cinderella's stepmother or a very strict mistress, almost in the parodic way. But her nature is much more ambivalent than that. So she's much more intelligent than that. And at the same time, she's much more manipulative than that. She knows how to be warm too. She knows how to be encouraging. Probably she's not gonna smile more than necessary, but she's gonna find the right way in order to get a reaction. And at the end of the day, we're gonna discover her real face, which is probably much darker than that. We have another four girls, and they are different people and different personas too. The way they relate to each other, the way they react to the same things, even the way they dress is totally different, and you see that just with one look because they project such different energies. If someone told you the story of Down a Dark Hole, you would envision Dracula's mansion or a gothic house full of candelabras, cuckoo clocks, and spider webs. And this is not what Blackwood is. This is more an institution. And actually, when you see it for the very first time, it's unique. It has a very strong personality, but it's not necessarily a dark place. But little by little, things evolve and they get corrupted, let's say this way, in a very specific way. So you start to see hidden corners of this place